During the House sitting, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, summoned Foreign Affairs Minister, General Jeje Odong, following allegations that the country's recent delegation to the United Nations General Assembly was oversized. His directive followed a matter of national importance that was raised by Muwada Nkunyinji, the Chadondo East Member of Parliament.
It has been reported that Uganda sent a delegation of 71 persons. 10 of them were accredited, 60 not accredited, but appeared as advisors. It is also on record that Uganda has a mission in New York, funded above $16 billion, at least by last year, to cater for our engagements with the UN. And equally, for months now, the Foreign Affairs Ministry has not tabled a codified foreign policy for Uganda. Right, Honorable Speaker? I now pray that the Minister of Foreign Affairs be directed to brief this House on how the delegation was sanctioned.
The list, which has become a subject of debate for the last few days, indicated that the Vice President, Jessica Alupo, who was the official representative, was allocated 51 slots, while the Prime Minister, Robinah Nabbanja, was apportioned 20 positions. According to MPs, many of those on the traveling delegation were underserving and sneaked in.
The Vice President, by our constitution, is number two and actually a president in waiting. I wanted to find out, Mr. Speaker, whether in this matter of quarreling and you will not find space for the Vice President to come and speak to Parliament on this matter. Because the leader of the Minister of Foreign Affairs accrediting the delegation had her as the head.
The ongoing saga, which has seen Nabbanja clash with Justin Kasue Lumumba for not seeking her permission, was a center of discussion in the House as members questioned the unbecoming feud. The Deputy Speaker asked the bickering members of Cabinet to cease fire to save government from further embarrassment.
May it please you that you ask of the Right Honourable Prime Minister to appear and assure this House that one, she is in charge, two, that actually she is aware of what took place, because being Prime Minister and the law of public media explaining uncoordinatedly her role in the botched, travel, would it be proper with the intelligence that she comes and lead of government? Because we need her confidence.
Side of government, some are using water, others are using fuel, and that's why the fire is not going on. And in such a situation in many countries, if you're not steady, Parliament comes in, and Parliament usually comes with fuel. It doesn't usually come with fire. So for now, it doesn't usually come with water. So for now, I would advise you that please use water on your side.
The Foreign Affairs Minister was given time on Thursday to take a statement on how he came to accredit a bloated delegation. Meanwhile, Parliament today debated and passed a motion to pay tribute to the successful East Africa Pamoja bid comprising of Uganda, Tanzania and Kenya for hosting the African Cup of Nations, with a strong call on government to commit enough funds to match the task to host AFCON.
The AFCON comes with a lot of strategic and inclusive investment and benefits to the sports sector and the economy at large. First of all, Right Honourable Speaker, it will give us an opportunity to bring infrastructural development in roads, sports sector, and we have been looking towards this as a Parliament of Uganda. Many colleagues have stood up here and spoken and encouraged government to build stadiums across the regions that we have in this country.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.